Challenge number one, managing your own servers is time consuming and can be frustrating. So let's first go in and look at what the workflow is to create your first server on Cloudways. So when you first log in, it's going to take you to this screen. It'll show you all your servers. There is an application view of that same thing to look at your applications instead of your servers. If you just click on the Add Server button, it's going to take you to a short wizard that you can use to create your first or next server. When you select, the first choice you have to make is what your default application is. So you can add as many applications to a server as you'd like, but we do need an initial application in order to create that server. And so if you're just creating this server to mess around, you can just select WordPress version 6.1.1. There's a couple of different options here. You can add a multi-site version of WordPress, and you can also add a clean install. Cloudways has a optimized plugin called Breeze. And so this version, 6.1.1, is just installing WordPress with Breeze. And this version, the clean version, is installing WordPress without Breeze. Now, I'm a big fan of Breeze because I like to use my caching plugin and have my websites go fast. And so I use the Cloudways optimized version. So we've got to name our managed app. So I'm going to just go ahead and give it a test name here. We need to name our server. So I'm gonna name that. We can also select a project. So I can create my project folders. I can also have, you know, additional folders that I can organize projects into. Projects are super helpful if you are an agency or you're an app development team and you have, you know, multiple divisions or multiple teams or multiple clients with different servers or different applications. Projects are just a way to organize what you're doing in there. You have to choose your infrastructure. So Cloudways is a flexible product, meaning that you can launch your website on DigitalOcean, Vulture, Linode, Amazon, or Google Cloud. You can create servers on these different platforms at any time. You can move applications between this different infrastructure. So it's really easy for you to create a website on one of these different infrastructures. If for whatever reason you needed the features and functions of a different infrastructure platform, you could move to it at that time. So for today's demo, we're going to pick DO infrastructure. You'll notice these little kind of disk icons here. This is denoting a premium droplet server. So you've got your standard 2 gigabyte server, and then you have your premium droplet server. There is a little cost change in that. So from 2 gigs to 2 gigs premium, you can see there's a $4 price difference. All of Cloudways billing is metered. So Cloudways is metered billing, meaning if you spin up a server and you use it for an hour, then you're only going to be charged about 3.6 cents for that server. So you can spin up servers, you can delete them, you can duplicate them, you can shut them down as often as you need. You also have to choose the location of your server. So depending on which infrastructure provider you select, you can choose different infrastructure providers. So with DigitalOcean, we've got London, Amsterdam, Bangalore, Frankfurt, New York. And recently we brought on the Sydney data center. I'm based here in the US. So I'm going to select New York for my data center. A common question that does come up is how many applications we can deploy. You can deploy depending on what server level you are creating here. You know, rule of thumb, I mean, a standard WordPress install is going to take up about 150 megs of RAM. And then depending on how much traffic you have, that's going to obviously vary it. Also, how many plugins you have is going to also vary how much RAM that application is taking up. But, you know, a 2 gigabyte server, it's safe to say that, you know, it could probably host, you know, 10 or 15 brochureware sites. I have seen agencies hosting more than that on there. That's not necessarily our suggested path, but you can manage those resources from within your server administration area. So you can see how much monitoring your servers are taking up, and, you know, how much the CPU is being used, how much RAM is being used. We can get alerts and all that kind of stuff. And so you have all that access in there. All right, so we've got everything selected here, and we can go ahead and click on launch now. Now you can see here that second server we're spinning up, it's now adding that server. So Cloudways is doing all that work instead of you guys having to you know, do the hard work in setting all that stuff up. And so now I don't know if you've ever seen those cooking shows where they start to show you all the ingredients and stuff, and then they show you the turkey that's already baked. Well, I already set up a demo server for our purposes here. But today, so once you create that server, it's going to install an application on that server. So you can see here, my demo application is already installed on my demo server. And so I can just click on that, and that's going to take me into that initial default application. And so we've got a WordPress website here. You can see there's a URL. I've already actually set up a URL, a domain on this application. I've already also set up an SSL certificate, and we'll look at that here in a little bit.